My score for Black Sails uses a number of unusual instruments, but without question, the most iconic and important one for this score is the hurdy-gurdy. I wanted to use it in Black Sails because there existed hurdy-gurdies in 1715. However, I had no idea at the time that I was getting started that the hurdy-gurdy would be so incredibly useful. In the early stages working with showrunner John Steinberg, we spent a lot of time figuring out what the sounds were going to be. Were there going to be guitars? And if so, what would they sound like? Is there going to be a piano? And if so, what would it sound like? The hurdy-gurdy was a great starting point because, unlike guitar and piano and fiddle, it's actually a foreign sound to most TV audiences. I mean, except for the fact that I play one, I wouldn't even know what one sounds like. So automatically, the sound is kind of alien. It's kind of strange. You have three strings strung across a wheel that acts as a bow. And you turn a crank and that vibrates the strings. And two of the strings are droning, and the middle string has wooden keys on it that you use to play a melody. It's like a primitive violin, and played artfully, you can dial in a pretty decent sound, but it's tricky. It's a hard instrument to make sound good. Thankfully, I didn't need to make it sound good on Black Sails. I needed to make it sound like pirate music. As I was experimenting, I found that I was able to get a lot of different sounds out of this instrument. It wasn't nearly as limited as I initially thought. And as I was playing my mock-ups for John Steinberg, I actually found that pretty much without fail, anytime he really liked a sound and asked me what it was, that sound would be the hurdy-gurdy. The first thing he noticed was the wailing bagpipe-like melody. And I remember him asking me, "What's that sound? What's that sound doing the melody?" And I said, "Oh, that's the hurdy-gurdy." In the next cue, John noticed a deep undulating drone that had these drifting, screeching harmonics coming out of it. And he goes, "What's that? What's making that sound?" And I was like, "It's the hurdy-gurdy again." John noticed that I had added this buzzing percussion instrument. "It's the hurdy-gurdy again." One of the last cues that I played for John had this very delicate little ticking percussion sound. It's also the hurdy-gurdy. Prior to working on Black Sails, I would never have considered myself a hurdy-gurdy player. It was an instrument that I dabbled around in and knew how to make a sound on. But at this point, actually, I've probably become pretty damn good at this thing. I used it as a way to explore new sounds and also change the way I write. Sometimes I wouldn't even write cues on the piano. I would pick up the hurdy-gurdy and come up with the idea on that instrument instead of on the one that I'm more familiar with. So that naturally pushed me into new creative territory. I think that the sound of that instrument is something unusual, and it's something that is iconic to the show, and I hope that as people watch the show and they hear it and all the different sounds that it can create, it becomes something that subconsciously audiences are going to associate with Black Sails.